Hey guys, Last Human Garage. Let's go ahead and perform. Actually, I have these clamps up here. I always go on tangents. These clamps always fall here. So I got a piece of wood. I'm gonna make a better shelf later. But that's not the point of this video. Oh, my shoulder, my bad shoulder. This is the SSD bar. Congratulations to the winner of the WeatherTech mats. Unfortunately, the post office was closed like by an hour by when I got there, so I couldn't ship it today. It's all addressed and ready. All right, let's put this SSD bar on the WRX. Super stoked. Haven't even read the directions yet. I think I better, so I have some idea how this works. I'll be right back. All right, guys, I saved you the boredom of pulling off my bumper. Actually, every time I have the bumper off, it's way shinier. I'll use my opportunity. I'll do that better later. You can probably tell that this one has sparkle and this one's dull. I'll clean those later. All right, how are we gonna get this puppy on? Let's take a look. Clean it later. All right, first thing you do is take off this. Now I think that I'm still gonna be able to put this back on from what I can see. So let's find out. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and let's see, get out my bolts. Figure out what's going on. Only need my long ones this time. Let's see. Oh, and I need these brackets for the rear. Now, I don't really know why there's two, but I guess that's just probably a universal part. All right, so we're ready. Now, these brackets are gonna go on the back here, and your bar is gonna bolt to those bottom of those brackets. So these brackets are what bolt here. Now, the kit only came with one washer, and ideally, you could probably use a washer on each side. So I did find two nice washers here that I'm gonna add to this mix. So I'm gonna choose to use the large washer on this side because it's thinner, sort of thinner metal. Back here, you can use the hole between the square and the circle, between the square and the circle. Then I'll use my small washer. Oh, perfect. Woo! Styling, profiling, limousine riding. Okay, put that in there. And I got room, just being silly. All right. Man, that's gonna take a long time to tighten that. I'll stop the camera when that starts rolling. All right, wider washer on the front. In between the square hole and the oval hole. Bracket on the back. The finish is one of the top things I like about these SSD bars. The powder coating just looks like high quality. Now on the brackets, you know, so-so, but the bar itself is so mint. All right, these are probably 3/4, just like the other SSD bar. Let me just check before I turn off camera. 3/4 and a 3/4. 3/4. Let me go ahead and tighten these up. Now, not all the way, because next I'm gonna install the bar and just get it so it's at the right angle here. Then with the bar just mocked up, I'll tighten these rock solid. And then you have to undo the bar and do some other work and put the bar on afterwards. I'm not sure if you can have the bar on before the bumper. I think in this case you can. Remember, the biggest maybe negative about this mod, which I'm trying out, I can always reverse it and see how I feel about it, is that you have to remove your lower grill from the bumper forever, because it comes right out, right where that is, the whole big unit. Now, I'm torn on that a little bit. In my previous video, I mentioned my black vinyl will probably have a white line at the back. I'm gonna see how hidden it is. Maybe if you can't even see it, the white line, too much, I might leave it. But if it's just an obvious white line from like 10 feet back on the back of the vinyl area, I'd rip off the vinyl. So that's all up for grabs. Let me tighten these bolts and I'll get back to you. All right, I got those snugged up so I can just barely move them. Now see, you do have to put this on afterwards because it's not gonna fit through the bumper with these big old pieces. So you put this on for test fit, take it off, put the bumper on without the grill, then you attach these because you do have better access then to tighten those up. So let's go ahead and get some bolts in these things. Make sure that my angles on these hanger brackets are good. Right in there. Let me get a nut on the back of that thing. They're actually perfect, but just before I finalize tight, I want to make sure that these bolts are in good. Just throw a little nut on the back just so they don't fall out. Like that one. It's not that hard, I'm just making it hard. Come on, spin it up. There we go, I just can't see what I'm doing. All right. Oh, okay, good. This isn't a, I hate lock nuts like the one up there, because they're so hard to tighten. This is easy, you just spin it on. Done. Okay. Angled, okay. Sink it back and forth, side to side. Looking good. Tighten these a little more now that it settled in a bit. Ah, nice. Nice. All right. Next step, you're going to tighten these final tight. Your final tight. Let's see. Turn it around. Okay. This is pretty, as you can see, pretty easy access. I would get my Mongo ratchet. Let me go over here. But I really don't even need the Mongo ratchet. You could probably bend this metal, it's so thin, so don't use your ratchet this long, all right? Pretty good. I don't want to break. I don't want to start bending the metal. It's pretty good, using a lot of force. Plus, it's a lock nut on the back of that, remember? All right. This one's a little harder to get to, probably just because of my harnesses. Let's see, can I go in there? Okay, I can hold it like that. There we go. All right, let's tighten this one, final tightness. There's no torque or anything, don't worry about any of that. Use your sense, common sense. Okay. Some shaking, that's hard, I'm pushing pretty hard. Because it's a short ratchet, you know. Alright, now I feel like I want to give the other one more of those because I didn't do the other one quite with that intensity, just to make sure. Let's see, what was I doing, like this? Oh yeah, this one needs to match the other one. There we go. That's it. The master brackets are complete. Next, I'm going to pop the lower grill off of my bumper, which takes a few seconds. Then I'll slide the bumper on, and then I'll start the camera up again, let you see what's going on. P.S. A little trivia. There's one thing different on the car now that is visible in this shot. Something changed that I've had a long time. You can see it in this shot. If you can guess it, throw it in the comments. quick note on your styrofoam. It's fine. You can reuse it for sure. It has a cutout here that the bolt's in. You're not bumping up against the bolt. And this is, you know, a little bit of safety. Maybe helps your bumper from cracking if you hit. Now, you get a little bit older like mine. I always do some tape on it. It just stays there forever. And I don't take this off because it tends to get knocked off sometimes after you've done a few bumper jobs. Then you're putting the bumper on and it falls off and you got to start over. So I just do a little bit of added security. Just cinch this right up. No worries. It's not visible. Just a little tip. All right, guys, you can see what I mean about the white. And also, it would be very hard to vinyl this across the back because you got all these brackets and everything. I guess I won't rip the vinyl off now because I can do it anytime I want. So I'll leave it installed and evaluate it for a day or two. But there's a good chance I'm going to rip off this vinyl if I decide to stay with the bar. And it's pretty good condition overall. I don't think I polished this one, but maybe I did, like the trunk lid, to get the scratches off. I don't know. I'll have to decide whether I prefer an SSD bar mod or a lower vinyl mod. It's kind of hard to have both. All right, let me keep working. I just made up my mind like 3 minutes after that clip. What I was thinking about is I like a little black on my front, right? I like a little black on my front. Back on my front. I like the black down here, right? This is my new black down here. There you go. That's my thought process. I'll still have black down here like I like, and I won't have a super uneven line there. Let me do this a little carefully, and I'll be back. All right, that did take 5 minutes. It was kind of hard. It was stuck really good. And I got that aftermarket body shop paint, which ain't that great. I found a little ding in my license plate like a week or two ago. I don't give a crap about license plate. Obviously, I can get a new one if I want. Just interesting. Probably someone's back fucking around. It's another reason the bar will be good. Keeps people off when they decide to park by Braille. You're gonna be hitting a bumper bar and not your paint or anything like that. All right, I'm working very slow tonight since it was my date night. Kids are having a sleepover at the grandparents. My wife and I went out to some Italian, had a nice little meal. Now we're both doing stuff we love, not together, and it sounds kind of funny, but we've been together a long time. It's not like we're newlyweds. And she's watching some of her favorite shows. I'm working on some of my favorite cars. And let me get the bumper on. Then I'll start the video again and we'll start showing you the fitment and how it's gonna end up looking. Pretty psyched. All right. Perfect. This looks like it's gonna be easy to bolt up. Get my arm under it to keep it from falling. Put a... There you go, a lock nut and a nut on the back. Nice access in here. I've never had this much access before. Something nice about the lower grille removed in some ways. Could save you very well from having to take off your bumper to do certain jobs and things like that. Especially if you drop something down from here. Oh, I forgot to clean my yellow fogs. I am not taking this apart again at this point. I'll wait till next time. I'm way too far into it now. I'm almost done. And I did such a careful job putting the bumper back together. I'm not taking it apart. I'll get a Q-tip. Give those a little rubby rub, rub, rub. See how perfectly, you can't see. How perfectly I set these yellows up. It's about 1/4 inch or less from touching this grill. That provides sweet, sweet visibility and pop. If these were sunk back like 3 or 4 inches, like most people's ones that are behind the grill, you wouldn't even see them as much. So these ones are just as far forward as they can possibly be. I spent a lot of time on that when I installed those. There's a video somewhere. These are not Oxbeam or Nilex. They're some other brand. parts, Sam? I don't remember. So now I couldn't even tell you. But they're a different brand. And they're a perfect match to my yellow fogs down there, my JDM A-Stars. 4S, JDM A-Star 4S, the fogs that run in both our cars. Best, richest yellows I've ever seen. The camera does not show how yellow they are. You come over for a visit and you'll see how yellow they are. All right, wow, look at that. Woo! That's pretty sweet, guys. I have to tighten up the bolts. That is pretty tough. I actually like how far it sticks out. Some people might say, oh, that's a little bit far out. I like that for toughness, for protection. Remember, you're gonna have a light here. You need some of that room there, see? And I haven't even thought about my license plate relocate yet, but it'd be really sweet if I can use my bumper plugs and use that license plate bracket somehow, hanging down or up or something. I'll have to figure it out, see how I might wanna do that. So I'll let you guys know. Let me tighten up these bolts by myself. I've always hated this license plate holder, but you know, it's just like I have to have one. It's just like, you know, the least of evils, the least of necessary evils. But you can see right here already, there's a leave caught behind it. And see those yellows? I'll show you what that is. I'm sure nobody will remember that because that was so long ago. And I haven't figured out what I can do with this bracket yet. I'm just getting this mess out of the way to think about it. I do have, first off, note that I don't have any holes drilled. These are factory JDM holes. I do not have any screw holes powered through this bumper. I have plugs for these, so I could technically plug all this up. You say, what are the yellows for? The yellows are to protect the white paint under it from the rubber of the expanding nuts, certs, because the rubbers leak a little oil or something, and they colorize and brownize, if you take these out, a little brown ring. And let me get a screwdriver. I probably still have the brown rings, because of course I didn't do that in time, like you should. These are just washers. But I did it, you know, after I reinstalled it, just for future protection. But let's see how tight these are. I don't want to break off in there either. Man, let me, I gotta take a little, oh, duh. This best thing about no rear grill now, look at that. I can reach in and deal with it. Oh my God. Let me try and get these out. It might be tough and I'll get back to you. Now you can see what happens to these when they've been in there too long. There's not supposed to be a ring under here in a perfect deal. This ring has formed because it's been that screwed together so long and expanded that it became permanent. That's the problem. When you take out your screw, it's supposed to extend and flatten out. You slide it right out. But when these have been in here, like, I don't know, year or two, like mine, this is a permanent ring. That's why I can't just pull these out. I have to use a little force because that's what happened. Another very good reason to have the yellow then, to not scratch your paint if you have to use pliers to jam these little babies out. That one's real expanded there. That was a tough one. Okay. All this is yellow tint. Ow, under my nail. Woo. All this is yellow tint. Boom. I'm gonna clean all this up. Even if I had to put the plate holder, I don't know, like here, do those line up? I doubt it, figured. I can drill new holes in this, no problem. It'll work fine. Even if I have to do that, and I drilled holes in this for the Forester one, for the plate. You can do all kinds of things with this. But I'm just saying, even if I did have to attach this here, now I can reach behind for nuts and bolts. See that? How sweet that is? I like not having a grill. I mean, some people might say that's too ghetto. You think this bar is ghetto, then we obviously have different taste. All right, I have my plan for the license plate, which you'll find out in a minute. Now I have, let's see, I have older Ooh, also, again with the no grip grill, you better not be prying these things out normally with a screwdriver or anything. You push from the back. Now I can get to it. Sick. Let me look at these four Subi Brothers paint-filled ones. Now, these are the most accurate. Someone said, at least one person, that the Subi Speed ones were not as good as these. It wasn't me that said that, someone else. And you can see these are really nice white pearly pearl. I guess I'll take the two cherry ones, even though I think, and I can tell, these are my first set because they're a little bit dirtier. These are a little bit shinier and popper, but I think I recall that the new ones didn't fit quite as good. Perfect. How's that? The front end's looking better and better, isn't it? I'm making you look at a dirty grill right now. What's wrong with me? Daddy's home. Mommy. Hey now. All right. Beautiful grill. This needs some soap. I'm not even gonna bother. This grill is all dirty, so I can't cherry it out for you on the spot for your viewing pleasure. And if, I mean, I have dings, ding. I always remind people this is a three-year-old car. Yeah, I know how mint you think it is. This is a three-year-old car. 31,000 miles, something like that. Woo! Look at that. All right, I'm gonna do a little tricks on the license plate and I'll get back to you. Okay, drilled two holes for the license plate in there. I will use tape on this one because this one is flat. It doesn't have the bolts behind it that the Forester had. You'll see what I mean. All right, two layers of thick 3M tape, the 1-inch variety. And it could already work by itself. I probably can't hardly pull it off, but I'm going to do two bolts just for backup, two screws. All right, guys, we're almost there. I was trying to think of a way to just do something, not that it's anywhere close, but just, you never know, put some protectant over these sharp screw holes. I was looking at all my plugs and everything, and I just couldn't find a nice matching set, and I thought of the most incredible idea. Silicone hose. Boom, protector, done. Woo! All right, guys, the red hose is a little hokey. I gotta do black on that, which will be better than silver, which will show up too. I gotta do black. I mean, I don't know if I have it now, but for later. Just looks kind of weird having two red tubes sticking out in my car. It is pretty visible. Just when I thought I was out, it pulled me right back in. In addition, the red ones were too long, making them even more noticeable. Much, much better. Almost like it was made that way. Almost like it's meant to be that way. Also, while we're right here, notice the nice gap. You are nowhere near the paint. Even if it vibrates, you got over a half inch. But dude, aren't you gonna put a light on it? When it arrives, I am.